What's up, everybody? T-Bot here with a quick video on how to take one MIDI device, such as an APC-40, and send it to two different programs, such as, say, Resolume and Synesthesia, or Resolume and vMix, or any combination of programs that accept MIDI control. If you have one controller and you want to share MIDI signals between the two, like, say, you want to use your knobs for Synesthesia, and you want to use your buttons and the faders for Resolume, you can do that, and you don't need to use BOMs in order to do it. The software solution is actually quite old. It's been around forever, and I'm sure there's lots of videos on it out there, but I did want to make a quick newer video on it, as it does still work with Windows 10. So let's go through this real quick. Really, really easy. First thing you're going to do is you're going to visit this website right here. This is midiaux.com. I will put that in the description. And all you're going to do here is you're going to download MIDIAUX here. The latest version is right here. So what MIDIAUX is this little controller here. And if you actually have your controller connected, what you're going to do is you're going to go into Options up here. You select MIDI devices. And you're going to select the MIDI input of EAPC40MK2, or whatever your MIDI device shows up as a USB ID. And it should show up as a port map object down here. Now, after you do that, when you move faders, press buttons, you will now be seeing all of the different notes coming in, and you'll be actually able to monitor what's coming off of your MIDI controller. Now, this is actually really nice, because I've had my EPC40 get a little bit of dust or something in one of the faders. And it's a nice way to confirm whether the program is glitching out or whether it's actually your MIDI controller that is sending ghosting signals. And if you need to clean your faders or something like that, you know, or if it's just sending notes that it shouldn't be sending, this is how you'll be able to monitor that. Now, in order to loop these devices, or in order to be able to send MIDI to multiple locations, you're going to need a second program. This is called Loop MIDI. And this link will also be in the description below. But all you're going to do, click this link, download it. Now, once you have that installed, you're going to want to open the Loop MIDI program. Once you actually have that open, you'll see that I've already created two different MIDI ports. But all you're going to do is punch in a name, hit the plus button. That will create an output. And then you can create as many of these as you theoretically want to. So you could have one controller controlling two programs, three programs, five programs, whatever your little heart desires. This is also really nice for things like TouchOSC, where you can create like a massive controller that controls multiple different applications. And it allows you to basically have one controller with each page controlling a different program, or, you know, the possibilities are limitless here. So what are we going to use this for? All right, cool. Well, we've now made our two MIDI outputs. And so what we're going to go ahead and do is come back into our Loop MIDI, our MIDI aux program, come back into our MIDI devices, and you'll see that there's these two MIDI outputs now available, Resolume and MIDI output 2, which I have made. And they'll be whatever names you have selected. You go ahead and just hit OK. And you'll see that you still see the feedback inside of MIDI aux, which is great. So now, if you come back into Resolume here, you should be able to go up to Preferences, MIDI, and you should see your newly created MIDI devices here. In my case, Resolume and MIDI output 2. So I can go ahead and select MIDI input and output. Do not utilize the APC-40 because it'll cause you problems. And now, if I go ahead and try to configure it, and I press a button, look, it works. But also, if I go into MIDI aux, it is also seeing the MIDI output. And now, in theory, if I wanted to, and I don't have a second program open to show you, but if I wanted to, I could also go back in, stop this, go in and say, all right, I want the other MIDI device to give me the input, and I can go to Shortcuts, MIDI, and I can actually do the same thing. So this is how you do it. And you can, again, make as many virtual MIDI output devices as you want. It's pretty straightforward. These programs are ancient, but they still work. So if you're looking for a simple way to route one controller to multiple devices, this is how you do it. Much more advanced stuff, obviously, you're going to need to use BOMs, but this is great for this purpose. Hope you guys enjoyed the video. Peace out.